believe it or not, most people don't want to heal. I know it sounds weird. They want to get rid of their symptoms. Everybody wants to get rid of their symptoms, but nobody wants to heal, which is
Why?
the cause of the symptom.
Why don't they want to heal?
Good question. Not very many people ask that. It's because they need their symptom. They need it. Dr. Sarno hypothesized that the brain is creating pain, for example, to divert your mind, your awareness, to your physical body and away from the rising rage within the unconscious that's about to become conscious. It's about to burst into consciousness. But we can't let that happen because we're told to be good people in life. We can't act out on rage. And so we internalize it and destroy our own bodies, okay? And so instead of this admitting that maybe life isn't going the way we wanted it to go, or our marriage isn't good, or we don't hate our jobs or whatever, we will limp the rest of our lives, or we'll go to the doctor the rest of our lives. The ego just won't admit to it. So Dr. Sarno said it beautifully, your brain's doing you a favor here. It's diverting your mind's eye away from what you hate to make you think it's a physical body problem. That's the favor. Well, a lot of people, they don't want to face their lives the way they truly are, okay? And so they'll go to an early grave, or they'll hang into a bad relationship, or they'll stick to a lousy job before they start becoming themselves at some point. And so basically it's ego, you know, that will not allow them to see the truth. Like me, I threw this book, his book, against the wall. My ego rejected it, the thing that was about to save my life. Luckily, I got worse. I know it sounds weird, but luckily I got worse. And he did say in Healing Back Pain, the real tragedy with this syndrome is people have to get worse before they'll accept truth. So I was a typical patient, I guess. I got worse. And so, but I was willing to change. I was willing, and thankfully, you know, this is my life mission now, my North Star, you know, because the universe wanted me to spread this message. It's infinitely intelligent. It knows who it needs out there messaging this work, you know, and of course you're part of this today as well, because you experienced it yourself, you know, and most people don't believe it unless they experience it. And so ego is really the biggest problem here. But, you know, sometimes, you know, say we lose a loved one that we love deeply. It's so painful, so painful, that people will just want to believe they have a bad shoulder the rest of their life because they can't face that loss. And so that's one reason, of course. There was a great, you remember the show MASH on TV?
I don't, but.
You're a young guy. It's one of the greatest American TV shows. There's a great episode there where the psychologist, this one guy was a spy, a double spy, and he felt this guilt and he was trying to commit suicide repeatedly. So the psychologist was a smart man. He programmed into the guy's mind to have his hand shake like this, so that he would think about that hand all the time and not the suicidal thoughts and how he betrayed his own country. That's the way TMS works right there. This was from 1972 or 1973. You know, to the physical, take it to the physical, take it to the physical. That way you don't have to deal with it. So people who can't deal with what's behind, they're the ones who don't want to heal.
So is it a little bit like, let's use addiction as an example. So a lot of people will turn to addiction, whether it's food or drink or drugs or any other addiction, because they're facing some emotional pain. You know, we talk about emotional eating. Does this still apply with emotional pain, not just physical pain? So if people are feeling that constant emotional pain, whether it's grief of a loved one or something like that, is that the same rules apply?
Exactly. It's an addiction. It's the same cause and effect, the same mechanism as addiction. You know, addiction is an escape. That's what it is. So we can't face our lives in real time, or we become alcoholics and drug addicts and technology addicts and gambling addictions and Joe Polish's friends are work addicts. You know, they're all work addicts. I tease Joe all the time, you know, publicly, because he's very open about his life, that he never got over the drug and alcohol addiction. He's now a business addict. And he talks about it every second of his life. You know, it just shifted forms. And so people who don't want to be addicts, of course, you know, they will give themselves TMS. It becomes their addiction, their habit. In other words, an addiction is a way of escaping. And think about it. If you're focusing on your body and not the sadness or the anger or the fear or whatever is behind it, you're escaping those dangerous emotions by focusing on your body. So it is an addiction.
And I, the reason I'm going around this, I'm just thinking for the people that are listening, how they can apply it to them. So yeah, look, you've got a back pain or a shoulder pain or whatever. That's one thing. But then emotional pain, that's pain in the sense of your grief or your upset or whatever, for any really long period. Like most of us have experienced losing someone we care about, someone breaking up with us, whatever it may be. But then there's other things that are a form of maybe ailment or disease that doesn't necessarily cause pain. So people that have maybe got skin issues, so it's not painful, but it's an inconvenience. You know, they've got rashes on the skin or they've got certain things on the body. Is that also the same thing? Can TMS still and the work that people can do with you help them heal from those types of from those situations as well?
Yes, it's called a syndrome for a reason, because a syndrome means a collection or a host of symptoms. And so, yes, it's skin problems, gastrointestinal problems, vision problems, hearing problems, tinnitus, weakness. You know, I had dropped foot. My foot was hanging down like this, with no more reflexes in it. And the MRI shows a pinched nerve, which it wasn't. Dr. Sarno kept saying, it's not pinched. Don't pay attention to it. It looks like it is on the MRI. So yeah, it can manifest itself in a infinite number of ways. And they're always symbolic. Where it is in your body, it's symbolic. Like the lady who lost her hearing, she had recently heard that her brother was going to die. Well, it was too painful to hear. So her brain did her a favor, shut off the hearing gate to help her, because it was too painful. Well, once I explained that to her, it came back.
I'm going to be sending a free copy of my book, North Star Thinking, Master Your Mindset and Live a Life You Love, to someone that comments on this video. And if you're loving this video, then hit like and subscribe to get more.